Hello and welcome to the weekly financial modeling tips by the Startup Station. We're going to learn today how to implement different revenue launch triggers. So there are three types based on time, based on the number of users, or based on the financial constraint. Most often it's a revenue constraint over a certain time period. So what we'll do in the example is we'll define each constraint and then we'll model each trigger and perform a revenues that will be based on that trigger, right? So we'll model how that happens. Okay, let's consider our revenue launch triggers. We have three revenue streams and we're gonna define prices so that we're just able to calculate how much money we're making. So for revenue one, it's gonna be $10, $20 for revenue two, and $500 for revenue three. Of course, it has to be whatever it is for your case. We're going to start revenue one based on the time trigger, which is month seven of year one. We're going to begin revenue two once we accumulate 1,000 users in total. Right, so we can put cumulative. Revenue three will be once we make at least 1 million in revenue again, cumulatively. And this is gonna be based on revenue two, right? So of course, all of these conditions can be changed. So the first step is to calculate the cumulative number of users so that we have a trigger for revenue two, right? So we're going to assume it's the same number for a month one, and then we're going to incorporate the previous month once we go forward, right? So the number of users is an input to the scenario. It would be based on your go-to-market strategy. We're not interested in that calculation right now. So revenue one, month seven. Right, so we just go to month seven physically, and this is when we have our users, and then we're gonna go to the price point, which is in our case $10, and this will be our revenue. So it's very simple to model a time trigger. You just physically start at the time when the trigger is indicated, right? Let's do the next one, right? The next one is a revenue two, right? And so what we're going to say here that if the cumulative number of users exceeds our threshold, right? If we reach at least 1,000, we will then take the number of new users and multiply it by our price point for revenue two, which is $20, right? And then if that's not the case, it will be zero. Okay, let's see if we implemented our trigger properly. Right, so we hit our 1,000 users in month four. As you see here, the cumulative number of users is 2150, and that's when the revenue stream starts. Okay, now we have to calculate cumulative revenue two in order to implement revenue three. So we use the same conditions as before. And then for revenue three, we would say this: if the cumulative revenue two is at least the threshold, which is $1 million, then we take the number of new users times the pricing for revenue three, and else it will be zero, right? And then we will go forward, and then we will see that we will hit that condition in month nine, and this is when these revenues start to be calculated automatically, right? And so the total revenues will be revenue three plus revenue two plus revenue one. We can paste that forward. And the total revenues for year one with these assumptions are gonna be quite big, $400 million. But I hope that this shows you how you can think about different triggers, how you can define them, and how to make your model very flexible. And there we go. If you like this video, please comment below, share with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to the Startup Station's YouTube channel for more financial modeling tips every week. If you want to learn how to model early stage ventures, we have a free masterclass. The link is in the description. Please go there, sign up, and learn how to model your venture in a way that's credible to investors. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week.